take it to him in prayer. I'm going to ask Sister Jenny if she'll come forward, and she will be reading our scripture verse for this morning, and it comes from Revelations 4, verses 1 to 11. If you get your swords ready, glory to God, she will be reading from Revelations, like I said, number 4, chapter 4, verses 1 through to 11. Glory to God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to read from Revelations chapter 4 through 1 to 11. After this, I looked, and behold, a door was open in heaven, and the first voice which I heard, as if it were of a trumpet, talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And as he thus sat, was to look upon like a jasper and a sardine stone. And there was a rainbow round about the throne in the sight like unto an emerald. And round about the throne were 24 seats, and upon the seats I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white raiment, and they had on their heads a crown of gold. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. And there were 7 lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the 7 spirits of God. And before the throne there was a sea of glass, like unto crystal, and in the midst of the throne and round about the throne were 4 beasts full of eyes before and behind. And the first beast was like a lion, and the second beast like a calf, and the third beast had a face as a man, and the fourth beast was like a flying eagle. And the 4 beasts and each of them 6 wings about him, and they were full of eyes within. They rest not day and night, saying, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, which was, and is to come. And when those beasts gave glory and honor and thanks to him that sat on the throne, who liveth forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him that sat on the throne, and worship him that liveth forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, 11th and last verse, thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are and were created. Amen. Amen. God's word.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're going to be collecting this morning's tithes and offerings, but before we collect this morning's tithes and offerings, I've got to say that from this morning, when Sister Annette was leading praise and worship, and I heard it this morning, I was listening in, and the songs lined up with what Brother Jim gave the word on. And throughout the whole of the day, everything matched up. And I just wanted you all to know that, and it probably doesn't make any odds to anybody, but just to let you know that the words and the songs that we minister each morning, they are given to us by God. And we don't know what the ministers have in store for us and what God has in store for us. And for some reason, even when I came in and said about worship, God knew, because the word matched up with the fact that we had to worship. So let us all just remember that, just to keep our mind and our heart steadfast on God, because he's pouring into us and everything matches up and everything is in alignment to God's word. Amen? Amen. Everything. Because when we give out the songs to the praise and worship team, whoever's leading, it's a week in advance. So we don't know what the ministers are coming with. But God imparts in each and every one of us what is sang and what he wants to be glorified in. Amen? Amen. 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 Glory to God. So I'm going to collect this morning's tithes and offerings. Glory to God. And collecting morning's tithes and offerings, afternoon tithes and offerings are a pleasure and a blessing, because we're giving back unto God what he has given to us. Just a portion. Amen? Amen. Amen. And we're going to be guided from the back. Glory to God. From Sister Selena, I believe, is here. Yeah? Sister Selena. She will be leading us to give our offerings and our tithes. And on my right, on your left, in the corner there, is our sister Annette, and she will be taking card payments if you haven't got the paper or the jingly jangly substance. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. All right. God bless you. For I'm building a people of power, and I'm building a people of praise that will move through this land by his spirit. Oh, Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, let someone just give the Lord a shout of praise. Hallelujah. We lift up the roof of this place. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As I sat in my bedroom the other day, place where I just meditate with God, I told the devil, this is war. Hallelujah. This is war. Hallelujah. And it's by our praise and our worship, hallelujah, that we can fight off, hallelujah, the powers, the principalities, the spiritual wickedness. Hallelujah. It's in our praise, amen. It's in our praise, amen. It's in our praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be feeling down. You may not be feeling yourself. You may have ailments. But it's in your praise that you will get the breakthrough. Hallelujah. It might be financial difficulties. It is in your praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil cannot inhabit in your praise. So let's just lift up our voices one more time and give God some praise.
Everything new, morning by morning, new mercy. Everything. stand up, bless my soul, and I hold up to be blessed you too.
Amen.
I serve a mighty God who reigns in heaven and in majesty supreme. So long I'm on its side, my life is surely guide, and I am persuaded God will see me through.
Yes.
I am persuaded God will see me through. I never doubt him. I only trust him. He specializes in things though impossible, but I am persuaded God will see me through. When you're going through the water, it will be there. When you're going through the fire, He will be there. No need to worry, no need to fret. My God has never failed us yet, and I am persuaded God will see me through.
Amen.
I am persuaded God will see me through.
Praise Him.
I never doubt.
Praise Him.
Oh, I won't be
charged. Amen.
He specializes in things though impossible, and I am persuaded. If you're a child of God, you may be tried by the powers of on this earth. Though like the evil voice, they've been defended by their God, and high up.
Oh, my God will see us through.
to see my nephew in church sitting by.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Thank you, Sister Harrison, for the reminder that whatever we're going through, whatever comes, what may, God will see us through. We can't lean on our own understanding. We have to remember that God will see us through. And I just was listening to every word from that song, and I remember it from when I was a top, but the songs are so, that song is so relevant for now.
Yeah,
amen?
Amen?
You get where I'm going, yeah? It is so relevant for now. Glory to God. So thank you, Mother Harrison,
amen,
for that wonderful rendition of God Will See Us Through.
Amen,
amen, amen. 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 We're going to worship and praise God one more time before the speaker comes on. And it lines up again with everything that is going on in here. And we're going to be standing to our feet another time in praises and worship unto God. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. And while you get up onto your feet, I have to ask, is there a poignant anniversary coming up for anyone? And when I say that, is it an anniversary of somebody's passing? Is it coming up or is it just gone? Can somebody raise their hand if that's the case? Somebody's passing, and it was either last week or within this month of October. Put it that way, in this month of October. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. See, my memory is like a sieve, and I wouldn't remember what people's dates and so forth that has gone and come up. It's only probably selfishly my own mother and family members that have passed that I remember. But God put it in my spirit that somebody is feeling heavy this morning over a passing. Somebody that's passed within this month, and it's embedded in their feelings this morning. And there's a heaviness going over them. And I see those hands. And I give God thanks for those hands. And we still pray, and we know that God will deliver you.
Yes.
He will always deliver you, whatever you're going through, however you're feeling, however long it was. God will still see you through the tough times.
Amen.
Because our God is awesome.
Amen.
He is awesome.
Amen.
Glory to God. And He can move mountains. He keeps us in a valley. And He hides us from the rain. What are the storms you're going through? And when you bleed, we bleed. Are we our brother's keeper? Yes, we are. Yes, we are. And as God imparted that to me, all I can do is feel your sorrow and your pain. Because I don't know what you're going through at this moment. But all I can say is that I stand upon the word of God, that He will be a mother to the motherless, and a father to the fatherless, and He will keep you as you weather the storms of life, because He is awesome.
My God is awesome. He can do. Yeah.
Praise. The psalmist said from the rising of the sun,
setting of that same sun. The Lord is worthy to be praised. There's a scripture in the Psalms that said, oh, that men would praise him. Oh, that men would praise him for his wonderful goodness towards the children of men. Hallelujah. Our God, who is able to do exceedingly and far abundantly above all that we can ever think or ask. He is worthy this morning to be praised. You know, we were just singing that song and the word came up, protector, protector. And I said, thank you, Jesus. You know, I have 7 grandchildren, only 2 children, but the Lord had blessed me with 7 grandchildren. And the youngest one, Fabricio, he has autism and he is 5 years old. And he is non-verbal. He cannot speak. He's not really aware of his surroundings or anything that's going on. And he's lively. He's very lively. And the other day I had his 2 sisters and his brother at my home because I look after them sometimes when my daughter goes to work. And I drove my car and came in the back way. And my 2 granddaughters, who are 15 and 12, came in the front way. But they didn't lock the door behind them. And I'm just in the house into an hour when they're all in the house. And I've got a kitchen and dining area and then the hallway. And I thought I heard the door handle because he's up and down and in the hallway, jumping off the bottom step and all that goes with him. And I went straight to the hallway and the door was ajar, only slightly. And I ran out onto the street and I looked and I couldn't see him. And I just shouted his name, Fabricio! And I could see nothing. And I said, Jesus! And as I did, he just came out from the other side of the road between some parked cars. Just making noises, going dag dag dee gai ai, because he was free. And I just said, thank you, Jesus. And as I crossed the road to go and get him, it's only a street, there was a car coming down the other way. And I went in the house and I was just shouting, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. He is our protector. And then I was also reminded of a scripture the Lord gave me just several months ago, because I'm always stressing about my children. My son is 42, but I'll still drive him from his office home, praise God. And I'm always thinking, God, just cover them, just cover them, just cover them. And oh, I tell you what, God gave me this scripture and told me to stop stressing about my kids and my grandkids. He said, with long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation. So he's not only going to satisfy them, he's going to show them his salvation. And I just said, thank you, Lord. You know, my sister said, it's in the praise. It's in the praise. The psalmist said, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You're in trouble, praise the Lord. You're on the mountain, praise the Lord. You're in the valley, praise the Lord. You're about to lose your home, praise the Lord. Someone is sick and dying, praise the Lord. It is in the praise, hallelujah. The scripture says that the Bible inhabits the praises of our praises. So that means our praises dwell with God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, he inhabits our praises. So never cease to praise him. Hallelujah, I will praise him in the morning. I will praise him in the noontime. I will praise him when the sun goes down. I love that song when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he has done for me. My soul cries out, hallelujah! Thank you, God, for
saving me. There has to be a hallelujah. There has to be a praise. Hallelujah. You know, when you're worshiping God, don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. But look up. Hallelujah. Praise God and just praise Him. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Well, my topic this morning is the next level. Hallelujah. And we read Revelation chapter 4. It's one of my favorite scriptures. Hallelujah. And I just love it. Hallelujah. There is so much to glean from Revelation chapter 4. Praise God. You know, I fell down the stairs on the night of district convention on the morning and I broke my leg. Now I'm a person that can't sit still. I can't stand. You know, even when I'm sat in the house with my husband, we could be in the middle of watching a movie or doing something, and I get up and he goes, "Where are you going now?" I said, "I can't sit here. If I sit here, I'll just die." I'm like always on the move. And when I broke my leg, you know, I thought I've always wanted to study the book of Revelation. So that's what I did. When I was laid up for 2 weeks, I wasn't able to put my foot to the floor. I just looked at the book of Revelation. And you know, the Bible says if you read it, you're blessed. So everyone needs to read the book of Revelation. Well, in Revelation 4, John finds himself on the island of Patmos. He is imprisoned there. Hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus. And John is the name traditionally given to the author of the book of Revelation. Revelation 1 verse 9 states that John was on that island. It's an island off the coast of the Roman Asia, of the Aegean. It's an Aegean island where, according to most biblical historians, he was exiled. And he was exiled as a result of anti-Christian persecution under the Roman Emperor Domitian. John would have been very lonely and isolated on that island. There wouldn't have been really anyone to talk to. There wouldn't have been any entertainment. The thought of being in such a place would have been probably very, very depressing, because we all need someone, don't we? Yeah. And so he would have been very lonely and depressed. But at the end of the day, he was not alone, because God was with him. The scripture says, "I will never leave you and I will never forsake you." Hallelujah. So God was with John on that island of Patmos. And Jesus says to us, "And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world." You know, people call me Lolo. You all know me as Lolo. And I love reading that scripture, and I take it personal. Lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. God is with me, and I love Him so much. The book of Revelation is a fascinating read. I have read it many times, many, many times. I think for the past 10 years, I've read the Bible right through yearly. You know, you get those yearly Bible readings. And I read it right through. I tried to read it right through twice this year, but it didn't really work out. But yeah, you should try and read the Bible right through. It's a fascinating read. I've read it many times, and there is so much to glean from it. In Revelation chapter 4, in which John describes the area around the throne, we just read in Revelation 4, the area around the throne. It was such a beautiful sight, the beauty of that scene. We see God in that scene as the sovereign creator. Amen. Amen. He is a creator God. Amen. He is a creator God. And many of us are creators. We might not realize it, but we are. God has given us something inside of us that helps us to create. Hallelujah. What He likes to see here on this earth. God is all wise, He is all powerful, and He has all authority. Today, as we try to gain more insight into some of the verses, my main focus is on verses 1 and 2. And if you could just bring up Revelation chapter 4, verse 1 and 2, to remind us what the scripture says. That would be very helpful. Able to do that?
Or if someone could read it, if we can't get it up. Is it behind me?
God kept knocking, but I used to turn over then and go back to
asleep and the knocking stopped. The knocking stopped. Praise God. God does all things to try and get our attention. But sometimes our minds, our thoughts are somewhere else. And we fail to hear what God is trying to say to us. The voice as John is standing at the door of heaven says, come up here and I will show you what will take place after this. Wow. Christ said to John, come up here. It was an invitation. Praise the name of Jesus. It was an invitation for John to be where Christ was. Come up here. I find that, brethren, so powerful because he wants to show you some things. Hallelujah. He wants to show John some things. And sometimes Jesus says to us, come up here. Come up to the next level. I got things I want to show you, Tess. Why are you remaining on the ground floor? Hallelujah. You need to move from the ground floor. But some of us, we need to move from the basement. Hallelujah. And go up to a higher level in Almighty God. That higher level is no more than the throne room of God. Hallelujah. You know, when Jesus died on the cross, the scripture says that the curtain in the temple was rent in two, giving us access into the Holy of Holies. Hallelujah. Why are we just standing behind the curtain? We need to go to a higher level in God. Hallelujah. A higher level. Because in these last days, it's not going to be much fun. And God wants to show us and reveal some things to you in this place today. There are people, and we know it. We even know ourselves that we need to go deeper in God. Deeper to the next level. But what is stopping us? We need to ask ourselves those questions. Hallelujah. He wants to take you to the next level. And unless you're willing to go to the next level, God cannot take you any further than you are now. Praise the name of Jesus. You need to go further than the level you're standing on, brethren, right now. Like John, isolated on the island of Patmos, God may put you in a season of isolation. You know, sometimes you feel you just need to get away from everything. You just need to be just you and God. Hallelujah. And God will set us in a place of isolation where it's just you and him, because he needs to speak to us. He needs to reveal some stuff to us. Even about our own homes, our own families, our own marriages, our own financial situation, our own physical situations, praise God. We cannot try to do everything on our own. God will put us in a season of isolation. A season of isolation. The purpose is for God to be given the opportunity to speak to you. Praise God, and receive your undivided attention. Amen. When was the last time we gave God our undivided attention? Praise the name of Jesus, when it's just you and him. Sometimes we think we've given God our undivided attention. If we sit with him for 15 minutes or 20 minutes or half an hour, sometimes God wants your whole day. Sometimes God wants your whole night. The nights are best because there's no one there to distract you. When was the last time then that we didn't go to sleep? That we stayed up all night just with Almighty God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He wants our attention. He's crying out for our attention. A higher level in God is a state of spiritual maturity that is achieved by daily pursuing him and his commands. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. It's a position where God's glory can be seen working through you to bring change in the world around you. Hallelujah. Jesus is saying to us today, come up here. I need to take you to the next level. Amen. You might say it's too hard, it's too much of a commitment, but the Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I'm reminded of my little niece, Tiona. She's 25 now. When she was in primary school, she used to go around the playground, and every day she used to give them this scripture. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And her little friends would come back the next day, and she would ask her, what was the scripture? And some of them remembered, some of them was different, didn't, but she was like a little evangelist, going round the yard, telling them, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. You say, I am weak. I can't go to the next level. I'm weak. I have no strength. The Bible tells us to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Hallelujah. In the power of his might. I remember reading that scripture years ago, and it said, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. I said, God, I don't understand that. How can I be strong in the Lord and the power of his might? He said, you have to be made strong. You have to be made strong in me. You have to pray. You have to read the word. You have to witness. Hallelujah. Praise God. You have to use all those spiritual disciplines that I have given you to be made strong in me and in the power of my might. You might say, I'm afraid. Hallelujah. Fear is a terrible thing. But the Bible in the book of Isaiah said, let God be your dread and let God be your fear. Hallelujah. We shouldn't be afraid of anything. The Bible said, do not fear. I am with you. Do not be dismayed. I am with you. I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. What are we afraid of? God holds the universe in his hands. We are part of this world. How much more us? You see, brethren, to get to the next level might cost us something. Hallelujah. Some of us are not willing to pay the cost or the price, but it might cost us something. It might cost us some sleepless nights. It might cost us some friendships. We might have to spend some considerable time on our knees. For all you praying people, we know it costs sometimes. Amen. To stay on those knees, wear out that little piece of carpet by the side of your bed. It costs us sleep. But we do it because we know God is able to do so much. It might cost us financially. It might cost you your career. For some, the cost can be high. But our lives are not our own, brethren. Hallelujah. We belong to Christ. And our lives must become as a living sacrifice. This is our spiritual act of worship. Romans 12, verse 1 says, every day we should present our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. This is our reasonable service. It said, do not be conformed to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Then we will know what is God's pleasing and acceptable will for our lives. Praise God. It is only then you will know God's will. Hallelujah. Praise God. It costs. You know, there's a scripture in 2 Samuel 24. David orders Joab to take a census of all the fighting men in Israel. Well, you know, this census displeased God. And David is forced to choose between three punishments. And God afflicts Israel with a plague, killing 70,000 people. Wow, that's a lot of people. The plague is eventually withdrawn from Israel. And then David wants to build an altar on the threshing floor of Arunah. Now Arunah wanted to give David everything he needed for the sacrifice. Hallelujah. He wanted to give him oxen. He wanted to give him yokes. Hallelujah. He wanted to give him threshing sledges, all free of charge. He wanted to give it to him free. And when someone wants to give you something free, you're like, yeah, I'm going to accept that. But you know, David declined. He would not accept the generous offer. He stood firm and said, no, I will not sacrifice to the Lord my God burnt offerings that cost me nothing. Hallelujah. We cannot give anything to God that costs us nothing. It has to cost us something. And it's hard and it's difficult, but there is a cost. It has to cost us something. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes it's very interesting. You know, the praise and worship leaders that appear, leading us into worship. Sometimes we can barely raise a hand. Sometimes we can barely shout a hallelujah. But you know, those people that come up here, they don't just come up here on a Sunday and sing. They practice and practice and they practice. Sometimes it costs them a lot of their time. Sometimes it costs them a lot of time on their knees. Hallelujah. Sometimes it costs. But they do it week by week by week by week. Faithfully. Hallelujah. Worship must cost us something. Hallelujah. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish but have everlasting life. The cross cost Jesus something. It cost him his blood. Hallelujah. It cost him pain. It cost him shame. It cost him anguish. But for us to go to the next level and be with him one day, hallelujah, it took his life. Worship has to cost us something, brethren. Hallelujah. Don't offer anything to God that costs you nothing. You know, sometimes you might only have a fiver in your purse or a tenner in your purse. The offering is coming around and you're thinking, oh God, this is my last. This is my last. And God says, give it. God says, give it. Yes. Praise God. And you barely can open your purse or your wallet. You can barely take it out because you know it's going to cost you. You might have wanted that money to go and get some milk or something. But you give it. And then you see God. You see the rewards of God. I remember years ago, I was there in my house with my two children. Barely a penny to scratch together. My neighbor Alex knocked my door. She said, Lol, have you got any money I could borrow? I need some food for the kids. I said, Alex, I haven't got any money. I said, but I'll look in my freezer to see if I've got anything for you. Now, she had four kids, I had two. I went in the freezer. There was barely anything in there, but I just put it in a bag and said, Alex, take it. Now, when I shut the door, I said, oh, you know, what am I going to do now? I don't even think I was a Christian then, really. What am I going to do now? And about 30 minutes later, my telephone rang. And it was my mum. She lived across the road. I said, hi, mum, you okay? She said, Lal, they call me Lally, my family. Lally, I've just got out my freezer, she said. And I got two bags full of food, she said. There's chicken, there's burgers, there's fish fingers, there's all sorts. Come and take them for the kids, she said, because I'm not going to use them. Within half an hour of giving, I received. Praise God. God is a good God. I remember my first convention, my first ever convention. I didn't even know what a convention was. Pastor Thomas took me to the convention in a huge place. I sat there and they brought around the offering basket and I didn't have any offering at all to put in this basket. Not a penny. And I felt embarrassed. And I went home. And then the next time they asked me to convention, I was in the same predicament. And I thought, there's no way I'm going to convention if I haven't got no offering to put in a basket. And as I'm walking across the road, my mother lived, I lived from here to across that road there from my mum. I'm walking across the road, and in my mum's house, they were putting in like new windows, new doors, all of that. And I'm walking around, and I'm walking across, and my thought pattern is, oh, I'd really like to go to this convention, but I need some money. I can't go if I haven't got any money. As I'm thinking that, I heard the voice shout, excuse me, love. I looked up, I said, you're talking to me? He said, yes. He said, we're putting in these windows in these houses, but the windows need cleaning. We'll give someone £15 for every window they clean. I did three houses and went to convention with my offering. Praise God. This is the God we serve. Hallelujah. When you get to that next level, when you give him all that you have to give, another time, I went down church, and I'll give you a few testimonies to encourage you. I went down church, dark night, rainy night, didn't drive. I'm walking down there. I had about £10 in my pocket. I got down the church. All the kids, because kids are my heartbeat, all the kids, Lolo, buy me drink. Lolo, buy me, what's those little coconut things, coconut drop on? They're like little pieces of coconut coated in like... What is it? Yeah, those coconut drops. Buy me coconut. So at the end now, my £10 is gone. My last £10 is gone. I'm like, Jesus. I'm walking home, pouring rain, pitch black, head down, thinking, what am I going to do now? Looking down, I always walk with my head down. My dad taught us to always walk with our heads down because you're going to find something. That's what he used to say to us. Walk your head down, you're going to find something. And as I'm walking, there's a crisp £20 note floating in a puddle of water. I picked up my double portion because I knew him 10, and this £20 note was bone dry. I said, thank you, God. One day, I was very poor, you know. One day, pegging out the washing on the line, thinking, oh, gosh, I'm so broke, it's a joke. Shook my jeans, and a note fell on the floor. I picked it up. I thought, oh, wow, tenner. I picked it up, and I opened it up. It was £50. £50 again, bone dry, out of the washing machine, bone dry, Reverend, bone dry. Now I'm thinking, in those days, I didn't have 50 pence to put away, never mind £50. God placed it there, Reverend, I'm telling you now, he placed it there, because if I had £50 to spare, I would know about it. God placed it there. And one more testimony. My mum was in the hospital. She was dying because she died of bowel cancer. She was bleeding out. But she didn't want to die in the hospital. And they said, we can't do nothing. She's bleeding out. We can't even operate because she's bleeding out. Said to the doctor, leave the room. Said to the nurse, leave the room. I said to my dad, leave the room. Just leave me here with them. I placed my hand on her belly. I said, in the name of Jesus, bleeding stop now. Amen. And that's all I said. A few minutes later, the doctor came in. He said, wow, the bleeding has stopped. Quick, let us get her down to surgery. They got her down to surgery, clip, 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 whatever they did, and we brought her home. She died in a home with Pastor Thomas, myself, my sister, my uncle, or whatever, all singing the songs of Zion, all praying. It was all beautiful. This is the God we serve. If you are willing, hallelujah, to pay the price, hallelujah, and really be sold out for God, he will do so much for us. He will do so much more than we can ever vision or imagine, brethren. Hallelujah. David said, I will not offer sacrifices to the Lord that cost me nothing. So David, he bought the threshing floor, he built an altar, he made his sacrifice. And you know what? After that, the Lord answered his prayer and the plague was stopped. Praise God. Maybe if David would have said, yeah, I'll have it for free, the plague would still be going on now. But no, he said, I will not give to God something that cost me nothing. Yeah. Well, we're back to John now. And for John, the sights he saw on the next level when God said to him, come up here, were extraordinary. Praise God. In the spirit, he saw a throne room in heaven with someone sitting on it. Can you imagine what you'd see on the next level? Yeah. He saw a throne room in heaven with someone sitting on it. He saw the beauty of God in an appearance of jasper and ruby. He saw a rainbow that encircled the throne. Hallelujah. The throne shone like an emerald. He saw 24 other thrones, and seated on them were 24 elders dressed in white with gold crowns on their head. He saw flashes of lightnings, he heard rumblings and peals of thunder, and in front of the throne he saw seven lamps, and they were burning. They were the seven spirits of God. He also saw what looked like a sea of glass, clear as crystal, and he saw much more. Brethren, imagine if you are going to go to the next level in God, or willing to go to the next level in God, when God is saying, come up here, rise to the next level. Can you imagine if John saw all that? Can you imagine what God is going to show you? Can you imagine what God is going to reveal to you? Hallelujah, praise God. God has so much more in store for us than we can ever envision or imagine. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise God. I cannot even begin to imagine what he is going to show you. Praise God. For some, he may show you his heart and lead you into a deeper understanding of him. Hallelujah. He will. The Bible said he will show us great and mighty things which we do not know. Yeah. But you have to be on the same level where Christ is. I often think of that scripture where Christ is on the mountain and the devil says to him, look, I'll give you all the kingdoms of the earth. Hallelujah. Praise him. Not that it didn't belong to him already. The devil is a bit stupid. But there you go. I will give you all of this. Now, when you go to a mountain, we live in Wales, there are many mountains. And when we climb to the top of the mountain, my husband will go all the way. I'm like halfway, I've gone back down. I can't go no further. But when you get to a certain height, or even the higher height, the views are extraordinary. There's mountain after mountain. There's lakes and rivers you can see just going through the mountains. Oh, it's just so beautiful. But can you imagine Jesus is sat on top of that mountain? Can you imagine his view? If we go to the next level, brethren, with God, try to picture the view. Try to picture the things that God wants to show you. Hallelujah. It's going to be beautiful. You're going to be blessed. Hallelujah. You're going to go deeper, deeper, deeper in him. Hallelujah. He will reveal the desires he has for you, and you will have a new hope. Hallelujah. Since you trust him to take you to the next level, you will have a perspective of your relationship with him. He will show you just how close he is to you as well. Hallelujah. Praise God. Is God close to you today? There's a scripture in Acts that says, in fact, he's very near, because it is in him we live and move and have our being. Amen. We just need to take that step up to the next level, like John did. You can get to know God's voice, hallelujah, by praying, talking, and listening to Him. You will also know to get His ways, but the scripture says His ways are not our ways, hallelujah. God will transform your mind on the next level, and you can see bigger possibilities. Praise God, praise God, praise God. God has so much more He wants to do for us, but we have to go up a level. We have to go up a level. Even me, I have to go up a level. Hallelujah, praise God, because the word is for me also. Hallelujah. I know when I'm trying to get up to another level, there's so many barriers, there's so many things trying to get in the way. You have to say, get thee behind me, Satan. Hallelujah. You have to trample him under your feet. You have to find some courage and strength. You have to ask God for boldness. Hallelujah. To reach the next level. We are individuals, every single one of us. Let us just try to picture sometimes in our mind and just say, you know, God, I'm coming out from among them. I'm coming out from among them because I want to reach that next level. Hallelujah. Lord, I'm gonna put this aside because I want to reach the next level. I'm going to put that aside. Because I want to reach the next level. I'm not going to walk down that road because I want to reach the next level. I'm not going to sit there gossiping with people because I want to reach the next level. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm not going to pay no attention to that because I'm going to reach the next level. Praise God. I'm not going to worry about my kids' future. Or what they're going to do, or where they are, or whatever. Because I want to reach the next level. Amen. And as you trust Him, as you walk with Him, He will do the rest. Hallelujah. Yes. He will do the rest. Amen. You know, sometimes people want to stop you in your tracks. They can see you going places, and they will do all they can. But we need to be like Jesus. Jesus set His face like a flint. And He walked towards Jerusalem. Hallelujah. His eyes, hallelujah, on the prize. Praise the name of Jesus. The scripture says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before Him, there's joy set before you. He endured the cross. We have to have endurance. He despised its shame. And where is He now? He sat at the right hand of the Father. Hallelujah. Fix your eyes on Jesus. Look straight in His wonderful face. And the things of this world will go strangely dim in the light of His glory and His grace. Praise God. Let us be determined to go to the next level. And I'm coming down. Brethren, God is saying to you today, come up here. He wants to take you to the highest level, to the pinnacle of the mountain. Praise God. On that level, hallelujah, you are in the secret place of God. The scripture says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. He is taking you to that secret place. And as long as you are in this secret place, you are connected and you are going to see and experience all the benefits of being on that higher level in God. He wants to give you today a mountaintop experience. Will you accept God's invitation to come up to Him? Hallelujah. In your life today. You know there's a sad scripture, and I'm ending with this. It says, O Jerusalem, how I long to gather you, as a hen gathers her chicks under her feathers. But it says you were not
within. Say it again. Oh, brethren. Oh, Gloucester Church. How I long to gather you as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings. Will you be willing? Will you be willing today to come to the next level with me? In Jesus' name, God bless you all. Amen.
Deeper, yes, I pray, and higher.
keep that till next week, but you know what? It was just so nice to go back, way back. Glory to God. We're going to hear the announcements, and Sister Annette will be coming up to give those announcements very shortly. Is everyone all right this morning? Glory to God. What a service this morning. Amen? Amen. Giving God thanks for the word and everything that we've heard this morning. It's just awesome. And everything lines up. Hallelujah. To give God all the glory and the praise. Amen? Amen. Amen. Bless you, church. Before Sister Annette comes to give the announcements, I just want to greet everybody. It's a little bit backwards, the search, in reverse. But I just want to, first of all, acknowledge Reverend Lorraine Giles. Didn't she speak straight from the throne of grace? Oh, I sat there in my chair and I could feel shivers down my spine as the anointed word was given to us. God bless you, my sister, as you travel back. So lovely to see your husband with you today as well. God bless you, sir. And your friend also that's traveled with you. God bless you, ma'am. We're going to pray for them as they go back just after Sister Anna has given the announcement. I also just want to welcome all of those that haven't been to the church before. I've seen some fresh faces, which is lovely. My sister here. Sorry, honey, I totally forgot your name. Do you mind standing? Have we got a roving mic? I also see a young man behind Sister Patricia there. Do you mind standing, young man? So good to have you in church. Have I missed anybody else?
Thank you.
If you could give us your name and just tell you where you come from. Tell us where you come from, that would be great.
My name's Shayna, I'm from Gloucester, but I come from Actually.
Ah, so lovely to see you, Shayna, yeah? Yes, lovely. God bless you, please come again. And this lovely young man here.
Hello.
Hello.
My name's Callum. I was born in Wales, but yeah. I moved to UK, I think, maybe 5 years ago.
Oh, excellent. Thank you, Callum. You can hear it just now. Excellent. Nice to have you with us. Please come again. You've got some fellow Welshies over here, so I hope that's made you feel at home. Is it Bonadar. Yes, nice to have you with us. Nice to have you with us. Also want to acknowledge Errol Johnson is with us today as well. Accompanying his mum, God bless you, sir. Nice to have you. I also want to welcome back Sister Anderson, who hasn't been very well. So nice to have you in the house, Sister Anderson. Mother Anderson, God bless you. Nice to have you worshiping again in the house of the Lord. Turn to your neighbor and say, it was good to be here. And find somebody else, maybe sitting in front of you or behind you. And just let them know it was good to be here. Come on, let's greet each other. The Bible says we should greet each other with a holy kiss. But let's just greet each other. Hallelujah. And hopefully there'll be some time after service. We have the welcome table at the back. That is being led by the discipleship team. You can grab a cuppa and some biscuits and just greet one another in Jesus' name. God bless you, church. I'm going to hand over to Sister Annette now to give the announcement.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's been a good day today. Amen?
Amen.
It's been a wonderful day today. Right, I'm just going to give the announcement. Just get up here. Okay. Sorry, just bear with me. I had it and I just went to check on something and I sort of lost it now. Right, okay. The announcement is as follows. Today, this afternoon, there are a couple of showcases, film showcases. This is still part of our Black History Month, and All Nations Community Centre will be showing two film showcases today. The first one is called Soul, And this will be from 4 o'clock through to 6 o'clock. And then Black Cake, and that will be starting at 6 through to 8 p.m. So if you feel like you want something a little bit different, please go to the All Nations Community Center. This is at Chase, off Chase Lane. And just go, it's free admission. And they put these showcases on just to reflect the Black History Month. So please go and support, because it's good to support our community as well. So please, if you, you know, fancy something different, just go along and enjoy these film showcases. Tomorrow, Monday, will be fasting and prayer from 10:30 through till 12 noon, as always. So please, if you are able to come, starting at 10:30 through till 12 noon. Also, there will be discipleship class. Okay, scrap that one. Next slide. So there's no discipleship tomorrow. However, because it is half term, there will be rehearsals for the youth day, which is the following next week, Sunday. So for all ages 10 years and upwards, if you can be out, they'll have all different kinds of rehearsals, and this will be at 6:30, because it's half term, thought come in a bit earlier. Okay, so if that's okay, please bear that in mind, all the youth from 10 years and upwards, to be here tomorrow at 6:30. And on Tuesday to Friday, we're continuing with our corporate hour power prayer, because the church needs to be united in prayer at this time, from 7 through to 8 o'clock. My sister gave a scripture last week, if my people who are called by my name should humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, we will hear from heaven. Amen. Amen. And he will heal our land. Amen. So we are here to come unite together in prayer from 7 through to 8 o'clock. You know, we're not expecting everyone to come every night, but if you can come at least one night as we come together, join together in unity, you'll be surprised. Or no, we should be surprised of what God is going to do. And he's going to heal us, because we need healing right now. Amen? Amen. On Thursday, the 31st, will be the day trip to Liverpool State Museum. The transport will be leaving from church here at 7:30 a.m. And also the second pickup will be from the All Nations Community Centre, and that will be at 8 a.m. I think there are a few seats available, so if you haven't decided and you think, yeah, I think I would like to go, please see either Sister Paula or Albert Gardner for spaces, and it's £5 per person. Okay, so that's this coming Thursday, the 31st of October. A few places, so they are going really, really fast, so you need to act fast, because they're going fast. All right, okay. Sunday the 3rd of November will be our youth day, so just to let you know, the youth will be in charge on Sunday the 3rd of November. On Monday the 4th of November will be our Let's Talk Education. You know, we've had a couple of series of Let's Talk meetings, and I believe this might be the final one. And this will be from 7:30 through to 9 o'clock. and this will be here at church. All is invited, parents, carers, community members who are interested in supporting children and young people as they navigate the system. Okay, so please come and support and hear and share, and it'll be very informative. You know, these things are put on to help us, and to, because some may not know how things operate, some need to come and just get more information. So when these things are put in place, let's come and take advantage of these sessions. Okay, so that's on Monday the 4th of November from 7:30 through to 9 o'clock. Sunday the 10th of November will be our next Women's Day, and the women will be leading both the 8:30 and our 11 o'clock service. So that's Sunday the 10th of November. Sunday the 24th of November will be our next pulpit exchange. Bishop Hugh Gardner will be coming to preach for us that day. So that's Sunday the 24th of November. Our next cultural day will be Sunday the 1st of December. You know, this time is going to be bigger and better.
Amen.
We had a wonderful time. The first one we had, it was absolutely wonderful. But we're going to step it up a bit. And if you would like to be part of the planning, please speak to Minister Tessa. Because, you know, when a lot of people come together and get different ideas, that's how it comes better. So if you'd like to be a part of the planning, please see Minister Tessa as soon as possible. Also, the ladies' retreat next March. Somebody remind me of the date? The 7th to the 9th of March. I believe the places are going very, very quickly. So if you'd like to go to the women's retreat next March, I know it may seem a few months away, but it's going really, really quickly. And I believe the deposits and the full payments need to be in pretty soon. Okay, so please, if you would like more information, speak to our women's directors, which is Sister Orly and Sister Daphne, for more information. Okay? Right. Continue to pray for each other. As we know, we've had quite a few bereavements around in the church and also in our community. So please continue to support and continue to pray for each other as some are going through challenging times right now. Please remember those who are not too well, so maybe in the hospital. Miss Rose, Sister Rose, is now out of hospital, so we give God thanks that the Lord is enabled her to be out of hospital. Amen. And please remember Sister Palmer, who is still in hospital, so continue to pray for her. Also pray for those, they may not be in hospital, but they're at home and they are not well. So please remember to pray for them as well. We have a prayer line every day, every morning from 6 o'clock through to 7. It's free for anyone who wishes to join in and pray. It's a free conference number, 0330-777-2413. Then you put in the access code 127-2767, followed by that symbol ASH, because that will connect you, okay, by putting that symbol ASH in. So please, if you'd like to, every day, 6 o'clock through till 7 o'clock in the morning. Okay, we have our welcome table. Thank you everyone for joining us today. And if you would like to have a drink, cold or hot, with some biscuits, because there's never any cake, just biscuits, but that's okay. Please have a chat to the discipleship team if you would like to. And just, you know, just have a drink. and just for fellowship. All right? Amen. Okay, we have some birthdays. We have a special birthday today. But is there anybody else who is, let me go to this side. Anybody having a birthday over this side? No? Anybody from this side? Over this side? No?
Annette?
I'm to Ruby.
Yes, I'm coming there. Natalie, is it your birthday? No? Annette, birthday? Brother Barry's on the 30th, I think. Yes, Brother Barry's birthday is coming up on Wednesday. And then we have Sister Ruby, whose birthday is today. Amen. Amen. And just to go that extra step on that, her birthdays are, it would be a constant reminder of the day she buried her husband. And so it's a bit of a bittersweet birthday, but we thank God that she's here and that we're able to celebrate. She's got her son sitting next to her this morning, and we give God thanks. So I'm going to ask Sister Ruby if she will come and take her position on the red carpet, because we've got special people that come on the red carpet. Brother Barry, come. We're going to have Janet and Jim as well to come, because they celebrated their wedding anniversary. They thought they were going to get away with it. But no, it doesn't happen. And also, we have someone who wasn't here last week. We did say happy birthday in her absence, but she's here today. Okay? Sarah was here. It's you, Minister Tessa. Okay, who wasn't here. Minister Tessa celebrated her birthday this week as well. So I'm going to ask her to step down here. And oh my word, and another anniversary today. This is wonderful. Now I have to just remove all people in the camera back so we can get everyone. Is there anybody in there? Oh, and Alfie, her birthday was the 25th as well. So she's coming as well. Oh, she's not coming, but we just recognize that it was Alfie's birthday as well. Isn't this wonderful? This is lovely. Lovely. Okay. All right. Do you want just to leave Sister Ruby on the red carpet? But if you could go to the other side, people can move over a little bit. Okay. Right. Oh, no, you said that you could stay this way. Okay.
No.
All right. Okay, the anniversary that side, birthday that side. Come on, Annette, you're coming out. Come. Okay, all right. Okay, all right, let's all stand and let's sing happy birthday. If you'd like to come and greet them, please feel free to come and greet them as we sing happy birthday and also recognize the anniversary, wedding anniversaries as well. Remember Sharon and Nelson also at the wedding anniversary the same day as Janet and Jim. Okay? So,
happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. that God is God. Praise God, our Heavenly Father. We give you thanks. Worship your name because you are worthy. Here we are, God, asking of you, Almighty Father, for guidance. Father, you're the Lord who administered the word to your people. She has done her job, Lord God, to protect her and her family. Back to new water. Despite the distance, we know you are an angel. But as we ask you to leave, go before them, you'll be alive. You'll be the God, you'll be all around. We pray, Heavenly Father, that our destination is safe. Not only the most from the business, we concerning your work here on earth. Pray, Almighty God, that you give them the possibility. Lord God, you went before now, but this moment right now, go before your people and protect them. We love you. But Father, thou art great, thou art mighty. Touch us in everything you do. Dismiss us all, Lord God. Cover us, Lord God, like Mother Hagar. Almighty God, protect us from the evil one. Your people will be troubled, but every Lord God. On the holiday, enjoy them. Nothing come to them. Moment, Lord God, we put everything into your arms. Thou art worthy. Thou art kind. And we bless your name forevermore. Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord.
Have a wonderful, wonderful day, everyone.